Hi, I'm George Miller from the Buffalo Bill Center of the West in Cody, Wyoming. And we're talking about glaciation in the northern Bighorn Basin. Well, here I am in my front yard looking at some very big rocks. When I first moved here, I thought these might be glacial erratics. And I've seen glacial erratics in Yellowstone that were big boulders that were left behind by glaciers. But these are spread all over the countryside, so they can't be glacial erratics. Let's go up to the Clarks Fork Canyon and see if we can figure out what those rocks in my front yard are all about. Well, there is the canyon, and it's huge. It's said to be the seventh largest canyon in the world. And we've stopped here at what's called a terminal moraine. So this is where a glacier, this is the farthest extent of one of the glacial periods coming out of the Clarks Fork Canyon. And this is where it dumped all the rock that it was pushing in front of it, like kind of like a big bulldozer. Only this is huge, massive scale. So my dogs really like this area because there's lots of bunnies living up in those hills. They like to chase. They never catch them. But look how long this terminal moraine is. It's an amazing collection of huge boulders and small boulders and gravel and sand. It's pushed up, and then water courses have followed these terminal moraines, further eroding them. So it's a really quite amazing place. And the vegetation on top is a little different than the rest of the Basin Plains sagebrush steppe. There are actually coniferous trees growing up there on top of the terminal moraine. Well, look at this big rock that's been pushed along. Now, that may be a glacial erratic. It was dropped earlier than the moraine. Well, here's the Clarks Fork of the Yellowstone River coming out of the Clarks Fork Canyon. And as I said, it continues to erode just the way all rivers do. But the real big erosive force here was glaciation. And we'll look at the glacial canyon in just a second. But I just wanted to show you the bend in this river. Look at all the big rock that's exposed there at the corner where the river's really cutting into that bank. Lots of big rocks are being exposed by the river. This is a pretty amazing place, Clarks Fork of the Yellowstone Canyon. We're looking back toward that terminal moraine you can see off in the distance. Well, further down, we can see out in the outwash in the plain, we can see how the river's following some of that terminal moraine and is continuing to cut little canyons in it. But it's very dense rock. You look at that gravel bar, it's really just gravel that's been washed out from the surrounding area. So this is a beautiful part of the river, the Clarks Fork of the Yellowstone River. So as we kind of look back toward the canyon, we can see those high cliffs. There's plenty of snow up there today. It's a beautiful, beautiful canyon, but you can see how it's sort of U-shaped, and glaciers have formed a part of that. They've come down that canyon. Here's some limestone cliffs that have sort of been uplifted, and we'll talk more about uplift in our next segment next week. But this is pretty amazing place here at the Clarks Fork Canyon, and we can see that huge canyon with a U-shape, and we'll really get a good look at it right here. The wind also comes out of this canyon in a very strong gusts. Almost all year long we can find big wind events here in the Clarks Fork Canyon, which continues to erode and sculpt that canyon. Well, up the canyon were these huge glacial dams and lakes. One called Lake Sunlight was huge, and it drained very, very quickly. So as the glacier melted, the lake was unleashed, and it flowed out, and the discharge was 650,000 cubic feet per second. That's as much as the Mississippi River on a normal day, all at once. And that's what washed those big rocks down into my front yard. Not terminal moraine, but glacial outflow from a burst glacial lake. Isn't that an amazing piece of geology here in northern Bighorn Basin? Well, we'll be back with more next week. We'll talk about uplift. And if you want more information, go to centerofthewest.org. Thanks, and see you soon.